Hello everyone, welcome to another interesting class of nutrition in animals. You must have seen certain animals like cows and buffaloes continuously chewing food without having any food in front of them. In that case, actually they are chewing their food for the second time, and that process is called rumination. And the animals like cows, buffaloes, sheep, goat, deer, etc. are called grass-eating ruminants. So this class is about digestion in grass-eating ruminants. So what are ruminants? Ruminants are the grass-digesting animals chewing half-digested food, or the animals which ruminate, and the process of ruminating food is called rumination. So what is this half-digested food? So when the ruminants eat the grass for the first time, they just give it a cursory chew and take it to the stomach. From the stomach, it is brought back to the mouth and they continuously chew it and chew it properly. So this second time chew is called rumination. And these animals are able to digest the cellulose, which is a complex carbohydrate in the grass. We humans are not able to digest grass. Why? Because grass contains a complex carbohydrate called cellulose. To digest cellulose, an enzyme is needed. The name of the enzyme is called cellulase. We do not contain cellulose, so we are not able to eat or not able to digest grass. But these animals also do not have cellulose. So how does the animal carry out the digestion of cellulose? In this class, we will explore what is the process of digestion of grass in these ruminants. So let us start. If we see the digestive system of these ruminants, we will find that their stomach is made up of four chambers. It means they are having a four-chambered stomach. The four chambers of a stomach are: first, rumen, the largest part of the stomach; second, the reticulum; third is the omasum; and the fourth is the abomasum. So what happens to the food once the animal eats the food? So when the animal eats the food, it does not chew it properly but quickly swallow it. After getting swallowed, the food arrives in the rumen. Inside the rumen, there is a population of microorganisms like bacteria, protozoa and fungi. And the food, which is mixed with saliva, the saliva present in the food helps these bacteria and microorganisms to thrive inside the rumen. So inside the rumen, there is a large contraction of muscles which mixes the grass with this population of microorganisms. These microorganisms digest the cellulose. Why? Because these microorganisms contain the enzyme cellulose to convert the cellulose into glucose. Thus, inside the rumen, the cellulose is digested into glucose. But interestingly, this glucose is not utilized by microorganisms. What is utilized by microorganisms is the fermentation product of glucose. These microorganisms ferment the glucose and convert the glucose into volatile fatty acids, VFAs. And these volatile fatty acids are utilized by the animal. From the rumen, the food comes to the reticulum. And here inside the reticulum, the food gets converted into a solid ball, which is called cud. And due to the muscular contraction and the opening of the sphincter at the end of the esophagus, what happens? This cud comes back into the esophagus, and through the esophagus, this cud comes to the mouth. Now the food is chewed completely and thoroughly. And now it is broken into very fine pieces. so that the surface area of the food is increased, and now there is another chance for food to enter into the stomach of the cattle. So what happens after the second chew? Actually, the word ruminate has come from the Latin word ruminare. The meaning of ruminare is to chew over again. So this rumination, or the second time after this second time chewing, what happens? The food goes again to the stomach. After passing through the rumen and the reticulum, the food enters the omasum. Omasum is the part where water from the food is absorbed. The reason being that from the omasum, the food has to go to abomasum. Abomasum, which is considered as the true stomach of the animal. Why it is considered true stomach? Because it has the enzymes similar to the enzymes of the human digestive system. Like the abomasum has hydrochloric acid and protein digesting enzymes. So that these enzymes do not get diluted, the water is absorbed inside the omasum. From the omasum, the food comes to the abomasum. Inside the abomasum, the protein is digested in the presence of the hydrochloric acid secreted by the glands inside the abomasum. So, abomasum acts like the true stomach. Following the abomasum, the food enters the small intestine. And from the small intestine, it enters to the large intestine after passing through the cecum. The function of the small intestine and the large intestine is similar to the small intestine and large intestine in the human digestive system. So, I am not going to discuss the function of a small intestine and large intestine here. But, here is an interesting structure called cecum. We have already learned that humans also have a cecum, but the function of it is not functional in human beings. But in case of ruminants, cecum is highly functional. Why? Because it contains the microscopic bacteria. The cecum, which is present between the small intestine and the large intestine, contains a large population of microscopic bacteria which help in the digestion of cellulose. And any fiber which has remained undigested get another chance of digestion inside the cecum due to the presence of the microscopic bacteria inside the cecum. These microscopic bacteria, of course, have a symbiotic relationship with the organism. Why? Because the organism provides the bacteria, the cellulose, the food and shelter, and this bacteria digests the cellulose, giving the nutrients to the animal. So, the bacteria and the animal share a symbiotic relationship. In this way, the animal has digested the cellulose. So, in this class, we have learned the specific features of ruminants. What are those specific features? The first specific feature is that their stomach is made up of four chambers: rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. Another feature is that they do not chew their food once, but after swallowing, the food returns back to the mouth where it is swallowed again, a process called rumination. Rumination is the process which helps these animals to digest cellulose and eat grass. Another important thing about the digestive system of these organisms is the presence of cecum, which also inhabits a population of cellulose digesting bacteria. So we can see inside the rumen and reticulum and cecum, there is a population of bacteria which help in the digestion of cellulose. This is all about the digestive system of ruminants. I hope you liked my class. Thank you for watching.